I told her, you can't expect them to jump at every offer of service. If you can't tell me more, there's nothing I can do. So she told me what she had to trade, her secret. Well, I mean the mother of all secrets. I told her I'd alert the circus, and she made me promise that I wouldn't give any details to London.
And you agreed?
Yeah. I mean, it was... I couldn't believe I'd got hold of something this big. I went back to the import-export and sent a message to the circus, graded flash, highest priority. Just that I had a Moscow-trained hood wanting to defect.
Anything else, Ricky?
I know what I am to the circus. I'm one of the scalp hunters, someone you can give you dirty little jobs to, but I just wanted to bring this one in myself.
Well, I understand how you felt. You wanted to do something.
I said that she claimed to have information vital to the safeguarding of the circus.
Anything more?
I said that she had information concerning a double agent. Look, I just wanted to get the proper attention, and I told them that this is the reason why I haven't come home. It wasn't because I defected or anything.
What did you do then?
I waited for a reply. I hung around for hours. I remember hearing the IMSAT call for prayer, so that's what? It's about 3:30 in the morning. Then the message comes through. We read you. That was all they sent. Nothing. Yeah. It didn't make sense. It was like they were stalling.
Then what happened?
Well, then all of a sudden, the Russians begin to move. It was nice work. Couldn't have done it better myself. The message was clear and I needed to warn her. I looked everywhere for her. I couldn't find her at the airport. I even looked through all the flight lists. I headed down to the harbour. And they put her on a ship to Odessa. That's all I know. I've done a lot of things in my life, Mr. Smiley, but I can't stop thinking about her. She wasn't even my type.